will come a calling. They light a candle and hope that it glows. And some just lie there crying for him to come and find them. But when he comes, they don't know how to go.
Venla, grown-up girls cannot be seen strutting about in such...
Oh, let me wear this one, Mama. I love this one. It makes me feel like a little fairy queen.
But you're already in bloom. Now you made me forget all of our good news. Just think, Venla. Last night, the stork finally visited your sister, brought her another little baby girl.
I can't wait to see her, Mama.
Well, put on a proper dress and take a hat.
Mama! Don't be cross. Don't be. But I'm an aunt for the second time now, and I still have no idea how it happens. Mama, please. I'm ashamed to even ask. But then, who can I ask but you?
Then, my child, you cannot imagine that
But you cannot imagine that I still believe in the stork.
I don't know what I've done to deserve this kind of talk. And on a day like today, go, child, put your clothes on.
And if I run out now and ask Gregor, our chimney sweep?
Very well, I'll tell you everything. But not today. Tomorrow, or the day after.
Today, Mama?
Venla Bergman, I simply cannot.
Mama!
You'll drive me mad!
Why? I'll kneel at your feet, lay my head in your lap. You can talk as if I weren't even here. Please, Mama.
Very well. I'll tell you. Child, I...
Mama.
All right, then. In order for a woman to conceive a child, do you follow me?
Yes, Mama.
In order for a woman to bear a child, she must, in her own personal way, she must love her husband. Love him as she can only love him. Only him she must love with her whole heart. There, now you know everything.
Everything?
Everything, so help me.
Mama!
Mama who bore me, Mama who gave me, Mama the angels, who made me so sad. Mama who bore me, Mama who gave me, no way to handle things, who made me so sad.
Mama who gave me no way to handle things. Again!
Re superum, sivae memorum, unonis ob iram.
Better, Herr Lammermeier. Continue, Herr Zerschnitz.
Malta coque et bello passus dum condet orbem.
Herr Willow, from the beginning.
Arma verumque cano troiae qui plumus ab oris.
Herr Robel, and?
Italiam fato profugis lovinoque venit litera.
Herr Stiefel. Herr Stiefel.
Sir?
Continue, please.
Herr Stiefel.
Lavinia Quae, venit?
Yes.
Litera multum enum?
Enum?
Multum olim?
Multum olim! So I suppose the pious Aeneas had already suffered in the days still to come. Hashti. Do you have any idea what you're saying, Herr Stiefel?
If you please.
Pardon me?
If you please, Herr Sonnenstich, can we at least consider multum olim as a plausible conjecture for how the text might read?
Egabor, we are hardly here today to conjecture about textual conjecture. The boy has made an error.
Yes, but an understandable error, sir.
Indeed, if we could only entertain the fitness of the conjecture, then
multum olim.
Look to the rhetorical balance. Multum olim introducing multum coque. A parallel, sir, between what Aeneas has suffered at war and those sufferings on land and sea just ahead.
Hegemor, since the days of Sarius, Aulus Gellius, and Claudius Donatus, nay, since the moment of Virgil's death, our world has been littered with more than sufficient critical commentary on textual conjecture.
Are you then saying that there's no further room for critical thought or interpretation? Why then do we even...
I am suggesting no such thing. I am confirming that Herr Stiefel has made an error. And I am asking, nay, demanding that you amend his faulty text and proceed from there. Do I make myself clear? Herr Gabor! Herr Gabor, do I make myself clear?
Yes, Herr Sonnenstich. Litera multum ille.
Gentlemen, together with Melchior Gabor, Lavinique venit.
Litera multum ille, et teris jactatus et alto, vi superum, sivae memorum, unonis,
all that's known in history and science, overthrown at school, at home by blind men. You doubt them, and soon they bark and hound you, till everything they say is just another bad about you. All they say is trust in what is written. Wars are made, and somehow that is wisdom. Thought is suspect, and money is their idol. And nothing is okay unless it's scripted in their Bible. But I know there's so much more to find, just looking through myself and not at them. Still I know to trust my own true mind, to say there's a way through this. On I go, to learn. You know, name the stars and know their dark eternal. I'm calling to know the world's true yearning, the hunger that a child feels for everything they're shown. You watch me, just watch me, I'm calling, and one day all will know. You watch me, just watch me, I'm calling, I'm calling, and one day all will know.
Thank you, gentlemen. Now, infreque Deus Latio, the following 7 lines of Pius Aeneas' journey, from memory.
Melky, thank you.
It's nothing.
Still, you didn't need
to. Think what Aeneas suffered.
But I should have known it. Multum ille, it's just... I didn't sleep at all last night. In fact, I suffered a visit from the most horrific dark phantasm.
You mean a dream?
Legs in sky blue stockings climbing over the lecture podium.
Oh, that kind of dream.
Melky, have you ever suffered such mortifying visions?
Morts, of course, we all have. Otto Lammermeier dreamt about his mother.
Really?
Georg Zerschnitz dreamt he was seduced by his piano teacher.
Fräulein Gressel Bustenhalter?
Mort Stiefel! I need hardly remind you that of all of our pupils, you are in no position to be taking liberties. I will not warn you again.
God, I dreamed there was an angel who could hear me through the wall as I cried out like in Latin, this is so not life at all. Help me out of this nightmare. Then I heard her silver call. She said, just give it time, kid, I come to one and all. She said, give me that hand, please, and the itch you can't control. Let me teach you how to handle all that sadness in your soul. Oh, we'll work that silver magic and we'll lave it at the wall. She said, love may make you blind, kid, but I wouldn't mind at all.
It's the bitch of living,
bitch. Just the bitch.
Nothing but your hair.
Just the bitch, yeah.
Just the bitch of living. If someone you can't stand.
See, each night it's like fantastic, tossing, turning without rest. Cause my day's at the piano with my teacher in her breasts. And music's like the one thing I can even get at all. And those breasts, I mean, God, please just let those apples fall.
It's the bitch of living,
bitch.
Ah, with nothing going on, nothing going on. Just the bitch of living, asking what went wrong. Do they think we want this? Oh, who knows?
Teacher showering in gym class.
Modeling is the best. Looks so nasty in those khakis.
God, my whole life's like some test.
Then there's Mariana Wheeler. As if she'd returned my call.
Sensing God is dead.
It's the bitch of living.
You watch me, just watch me.
Trying to get ahead.
I'm calling in one
just
day.
Just the bitch of living. Just getting out of bed. Oh, it's the bitch of living. Living, living. Oh, getting what you get. Just the bitch of living.
And knowing this is it.
God, is this it? This can't be it. Oh God, what a bitch.
All right, gentlemen, turn in your verses, clear away your personal effects. I'll see you all tomorrow, 7 a.m.
Well, I'm off.
Me too.
Oh, I'll walk with you.
You will?
Sure, we'll huddle over the Homer, maybe do a little Achilles and Patroclus.
Melchior, Mort,
home to Bach.
Fräulein Drossenbustenhalter will not be kept waiting.
Melky! 80 lines of Homer, all those quadratic equations. I'll be up all night again and I still won't get through it all. Try and sleep. Who can sleep? I'll be haunted by another one of those nightmares.
Oh yes, your dreams.
Melky, why? Why am I haunted by the legs of a woman? By the deepening conviction, some dark part of my destiny may lie there between them.
All right, then. I'll tell you. I learned it myself from books, but prepare yourself. It made an atheist out of me.
So? No, I can't talk it. Not here. Do me a favor, write it down, all of it. Conceal it in my satchel after gymnastics tomorrow. If you like, you could add some illustrations in the margins.
top to bottom.
Everything.
Unfathomable, Fraulein Nuppeldick!
Nochenbroch!
Look at that! Melchior Gabor, a young man of distinct intellectual capability.
Thoroughly distinct.
A young man who could be our finest pupil.
Our finest, Nochenbroch.
But there he is, cavorting himself, polluting about with that.
Neurasthenic imbecile, Mort Stiefel.
Thank heaven the upper grade holds only 60.
Ooh, and Vendla, what will you wear to Greta Brandenburg's wedding?
Mama said we cannot go.
To Greta's wedding?
Because she's marrying that forest inspector.
Mama felt it was a little improper.
But they're decking the entire sanctuary in orchids and chrysanthemums.
Mama said no.
Well, I certainly hope your mama approves the man I marry.
And the man I marry.
Well, we all know who Taya wants to marry.
Melchior Gabor.
And who doesn't?
He is rather handsome.
So wonderful.
But not so wonderful as the sad, soulful, sleepyhead Mort Stiefel.
Mort Stiefel?
How can you even compare them?
Melchior Gabor, he's such a radical. And you know what the whisper is? He doesn't believe in anything, not in God, not in heaven, not in a single thing in this world.
Oh. They say he's the best at everything, Latin, Greek, trigonometry.
And the best part is, he doesn't care a whit about any of it.
In the midst of this nothing, this mist of life, still there's this one thing just to see you go by.
It's almost like loving, sad as that is.
It may not be cool, but it's so where I live.
It's like I'm your lover, or more like your ghost. I spend the day wondering what you do, where you go.
I try and just kick it, but then what can I do? We've all got our junk, and my junk is you.
See us winter walking after the storm. It's chill in the wind, but it's warm in your arms. They saw bones go blind. May not be true. We've all got our junk, and my junk is you.
Well done, Georg. And now the prelude in C minor.
Have you prayed tonight, Testimona? You don't look like you're praying. Lying there, contemplating the coming bliss.
Anshin, are you all right in there?
My son can't, Father, but I'll be fine.
Yes?
Fine.
All right, then.
Darling, don't think I take your murder lightly. The truth is, I can hardly bear to think of the coming nights ahead. But the truth is, it's sucking the marrow from my very bones seeing you lie there. Motionless, staring at me so innocently. One of us must go. It's you or me.
No, no, Georg! Again! And this time bring out the left hand.
Darling, why? Why do you press your knees together? Even now, on the brink of eternity, don't you see it's your terrible chastity that's
Anshin, that's enough in there!
Yes, sir?
Back to bed! Son!
1 minute. One last kiss. Those soft white thighs, those girlish breasts, those cruel, cruel knees!
Repetez, s'il vous plaît!
Well, you have to excuse me. I know it's so off. I love when you do stuff that's rude and so wrong.
I go up to my room, turn the stereo on, shoot up some you, and the you was some song.
I lie back,
drifting,
drifting.
I hate out the scene.
I find
all the rush,
all the rush,
all the dreams.
The dreams,
the things I should do.
We've all got our junk,
oh,
yeah,
junk,
yeah,
and my junk is you,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
Still with me,
October. The question is shame. What is its origins, and why are we hounded by its miserable shadow? Does the mare feel shame when she mates with the stallion? Are they deaf to everything their loins are telling them until they're granted a marriage certificate? I think not. To my mind, shame is nothing but a product of education. Meanwhile, old Father Kalbach still blindly insists in every single sermon that it is deeply rooted into our sinful human nature, which is why I now refuse to go to church.
Melchior!
Yes, Mama?
Mort, Stiefel to see you.
Sorry I'm so late. I yanked on a jacket, ran a brush through my hair, and dashed like some phantom to get here.
You slept through the day?
I'm exhausted, Melky. I was up till 3 a.m. reading that essay you gave me, till I couldn't see straight.
Sit, let me roll you a smoke.
Melky, look, I'm trembling. Last night I prayed like Christ in Gethsemane. Please, God, give me consumption and take these sticky dreams away from me.
With any luck, he'll ignore that prayer.
Melky, I can't focus on anything. Even now, I see and hear and feel quite clearly, yet everything seems so strange.
But all those illustrations I gave you, didn't they help illuminate your dreams?
They only multiplied everything 10 times! Now instead of merely seeing stockings, I'm plagued by labia majora and...
Well, here we are with tea. Herr Stiefel, how are you?
Very well, thank you, Frau Gabor.
Yes?
Just think, Mama. Mort was up reading all through the night.
Conjugating Greek.
You must take care of yourself, Mort. Surely your health is more important than some ancient Greek. And what have you been reading, Melchior?
Goethe's Faust, actually.
Really? At your age?
Oh, it's so beautiful, Mama.
Still, I should have thought. But you boys are now of an age to decide for yourselves what is good for you and what is not. If you need anything else, children, call me.
Well, your mother certainly is remarkable.
Until she catches her son reading Goethe.
I think she was referring to the story of Gretchen and her illegitimate child.
Yes. You see how obsessively everyone fixes on that story? It's as if the entire world was mesmerized by penis and vagina.
Well, I am! And all the more so, I'm afraid, after reading your essay. This part here, what you wrote about the female, is it true?
Of course.
But how could you understand that, Melky? What it feels like for the woman?
Protecting yourself? Defending yourself until finally you surrender and feel heaven break through? I just put myself in her place and imagine, I guess.
Really? What it feels like for the woman?
Where I go, when I go there, no more memory anymore. Only drifting on some ship. The wind that whispers of the distance to shore.
Where I go, when I go there, no more listening anymore. Only hymns upon your lips, a mystic wisdom rising with them to shore.
Touch me just like that, and that.
Must admit that the differing genitalia, it truly is daunting how everything might
measure up, fit more. It's not that I'm saying
not that I'm saying I would ever not whatever not want, whatever wanted.
Mort, I have to go.
Mort, wait.
Touch me.
Elfior, what is it? Has Mort gone?
Yes.
Well, he does look awfully pale, don't you think? I wonder, is that Faust really the best thing for him? Melchior Gabor?
Fenla Bergman? Like a tree nymph fallen from the branches. What are you doing all alone up here?
Mom is making May wine. I thought I'd surprise her with some woodruff. And you?
This is my favorite spot. My private place for thinking.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No. No, please. So, how have you been doing?
Well, this morning was wonderful. Our youth group brought baskets of food and clothing to the day laborers' children.
I remember when we used to do that together.
You should have seen their faces, Melchior. How much we brightened their day.
It's actually something I've been thinking a lot about.
The day laborers?
Our little acts of charity. What do you think, Fenla? Can our Sunday school deeds really make a difference?
They have to. Of course. What other hopes do those people have?
I don't know exactly, but I fear the industry is firmly placing itself fast against them.
Against us all, then.
Yes, thank you.
It seems to me what serves each of us best is what serves all of us best.
Indeed. Fenla Bergman, I have known you all these years, and we have never truly talked.
We have so few opportunities now that we're older.
True. In a more progressive world, of course, boys and girls could all attend the same school, together. Wouldn't that be remarkable?
What time is it?
Must be close to 4.
Oh, I thought it must be later. I paused and lay by the mouse by the stream and just let myself dream. I thought it must be later.
Oh, surely then you have a minute to sit. When you sit back against this oak and stare up at the clouds, you begin to think hypnotic things.
I have to be back before 5.
But when you lie here, a strange and wonderful peace settles over you.
Well, for a moment, maybe. Just too unreal of this. Watching the words fall from my lips.
Baiting some girl with hypotheses.
Haven't you heard the word of your body?
Don't feel a thing you wish.
Grasping at pearls with my fingertips.
Holding her hand like some little tease.
Haven't you heard the word of your wanting? Oh, I'm gonna be wounded. Oh, I'm gonna be your wound. Oh, I'm gonna bruise you.
Just too unreal of this.
Watching his words slip through my fist.
Playing with her in your fantasies.
Haven't you heard the word?
How I want you. Together, then. I'll have you on the bridge in 10 minutes.
There he is!
So, did you get caught?
No, thank God.
But you're trembling.
For joy, for pure and certain joy.
Cross your heart.
Twice over.
Melchior!
Mort, I've been looking all over for you.
He snuck into the headmaster's office.
Mort, what were you thinking?
I just had to, but the good news is I passed.
The middle terms, that is.
Yes, now everything will be decided by the final exams, but still, I know I passed. Truly, heaven must feel like this.
Well, well, Fraulein Nuppeldick.
Nachenbrach.
Now that skittish, neuropathic moron
Mort Stiefel
has somehow passed our middle term exams, it would appear we face a certain dilemma. The upper grade, as you know, will hold only 60. I hardly think we can promote 61.
Hardly, Herr Nachenbrach. But let us look to the finals ahead.
Ah.
Remember, it is I who shall be marking them.
So I am assured the good name of our school is secure.
Shall we take the short way home?
No, by the bridge.
After 2 hours marching with that medicine ball.
Oh, come on.
Someone wants to see has Melky Gabor taken a raft down.
Last one there has to hold hands with Hanshin.
Oh, Martha, careful, your brain's coming loose. Oh.
Just let it. Isn't it a nuisance for you, day and night? You may not cut it short, you may not wear it down.
Tomorrow, I'm bringing scissors.
For God's sakes, Madame Papa beats me enough as it is.
Really?
No, it's nothing.
Martha,
we're your friends.
Well, when I don't do as he likes.
What?
Some nights, Hoppy yanks out his belt.
Where is your mama?
We have rules in this house. Your father must not be disobeyed. The other night, I ran for the door. Out the door? All right, I like that. That's where you'll spend the night, out on the street.
No.
It was so cold.
My God. He beats you with the belt?
Anything.
The buckle?
Right there.
Oh my God! Martha!
The welts are terrible.
We must tell someone.
No.
But we must.
They throw me out for good.
Like what happened to Ilse, you mean?
Remember?
But Stu!
Anna, no! Just look what's become of Ilse now, living who knows where with who knows who.
I just wish I could somehow go through it for you.
My Uncle Klaus says, if you do not discipline a child, you do not love it.
That must be. When I have children, I'll let them be free. And they'll grow strong and tall.
Free? But then how will we know what to do if our parents don't tell us?
Martha, darling, time for bed now.
There's a part I can't tell about the dark I know well.
Martha, put on your new nightgown, the pretty ruffled one your father bought you.
You say time for bed now, child. Mom just smiles that smile, just like she never saw me, just like she never saw me. So I leave wanting just to hide, knowing deep inside you are coming to me. You say all you want is just a kiss, good night. Then you hold me and you whisper, child, the Lord won't mind. It's just you and me, child, your beauty. God, it's good to love and ain't it good tonight? You ain't seen nothing yet, gonna treat.
November 27. The trouble is, the terrible prerogative of the parentocracy in secondary education.
Herr Stiefel, may we have a word with you?
A world where teachers like parents, view us as merely so much raw material for an obedient and productive society. A unified, military-like body where all that is weak must be hammered away. Where the progress of the students reflects back only on the rank and order of the faculty. And therefore, a single low mark can be seen as a threat to society and as—
Melchior!
You.
I was lying by the stream and then I saw you here.
Yes.
So,
the stream, dreaming again.
I was, I guess.
What were you dreaming of?
Silly.
Tell me.
I dreamed I was a clumsy little girl who had spilled my father's coffee. And when he'd seen what I'd done, he yanked out his welt and he whipped me.
Vanla. That kind of thing doesn't happen anymore, only in the stories.
Martha Bessel. She's beaten almost every evening. The next day you can see the welts. It's terrible. Really, it makes you boiling hot to hear her tell it. Lately, I can't think about anything else.
Someone should file a complaint.
You know, I've never been beaten. Not once. I can't even imagine it. It must be just awful.
I don't think anyone's ever better for it.
I've tried hitting myself to see how it feels, really, inside. With this switch, for example, it's tough and thin.
It'd draw blood.
You mean if you beat me with it?
Beat you?
Me.
Fenla, what are you thinking?
Nothing.
I can never beat you.
But if I let you?
Never.
But if I asked you to?
Have you lost your mind?
Martha Bessel, she told me—
Fenla, you can't end someone being beaten.
But I've never been beaten. My entire life, I've never felt—
What?
Anything. Melchior, please. I don't feel it.
Maybe not with your dress on.
On my legs, then.
Fenla.
Come on, please.
I'll teach you to say please. How's that?
I still don't feel it.
And that?
Martha's father, he draws blood, Melky.
And that?
Nothing.
And that?
Nothing.
You bitch, I'll beat the hell out of you.
Father?
Morris! Yes?
I was wondering, hypothetically speaking, what would happen if...
If?
If one day I failed. Not that I'm...
You're telling me that you failed?
No, I only meant that...
You failed, haven't you?
Father, no!
I can see it on your face!
Father, no! Father, please!
So! Finally come to this! Can't say I'm surprised! Failed! So now what are your mother and I supposed to do? You tell me, son, what? How could you show our face at the missionary society? How can I go to the bank? How will we go to church? What do we say? My son failed? Failed! Thank God my father never lived to see this day.
Dear Herr Stiefel, Moritz, I've spent the entire day thinking about your note. Truly, it touched me, it did, that you would think of me as a friend. Of course, I was saddened to hear that your exams came off rather less well than you hoped, and that you will not be promoted come fall. And yet I must say straight away that fleeing to America is hardly the solution. And even if it were, I cannot provide the money request.
Well, fine, not like it's even worth the time. Still, you know, you wanted more, okay, so nothing's changed, heard that before.
You would do me wrong, Herr Stiefel, to read into my refusal any lack of affection. On the contrary, as Melchior's mother, I truly believe it to be my duty to curb his momentary.
The thing that sucks, okay, for me, $1,000 a mic scot-free, and I mean, please, it's all I need. Get real okay by now, you know the score.
Should you like, I am ready to write to your parents. I will try to convince them that no one could have worked harder last semester, and also that too rigorous a condemnation of your current misfortune could...
You wanna laugh, that's too absurd. You start to ask, can't hear a word. You're gonna crash and burn, right? Tell me more.
Still, Herr Stiefel, one thing in your letter disturbed me. Your, what shall we call it? Veiled threat that, should escape not be possible, you would take your own life.
Okay, so now we do the play. Act like we so care. No way, you're right, my folks. Well, okay. Babe, that's how it goes.
My dear boy, the world is filled with men. Businessmen, scientists, scholars even, who have done rather poorly in school and yet gone on to brilliant careers. Consider, for example, that...
They're not my home, not anymore. Not like they saw before. Still I'll split and they're like, well,
present misfortune will have no effect on my feelings for you or on your relationship with Melchior.
Well, fine, not like it's even worth the time. But still, you know, you wanted more.
Okay, so nothing's changed.
Heard that before. You wanna laugh, it's too absurd. You start to ask, can't hear a word.
You're gonna crash and burn.
Right, tell me more. You start.
I am unchangingly and most fondly yours, Fanny Gabor.
Just fuck it, right enough, that's it. You'll still go on well for a bit. Another day of utter shit. And then there were none. And then there were none. And then there were none. And then there were none.
Left in the cold, I'm locked out of peace with no key. peace to my soul.
Someone said he's been missing all day.
I expect he's had his fill of Christingle.
Perhaps. You know, I have your journal.
You do?
You left it the other day. I confess, I tried reading part of
it. Just leave it. Please.
Melchior, I'm sorry about what happened. Truly, I am. I understand why you'd be angry at me.
Don't.
But how can I not?
Please.
But it was my fault then.
No. It was me. All me. Something in me started when I hit you.
Something in me too.
But I hurt you.
Yes, but still...
No more! My God, no more! Just... Please. I think you should go.
Won't you come out to the meadow now, Melchior? It's dark in here, and stuffy. We can run in the rain, get soaked to the skin, and not even care.
Forgive me.
It was me, all me.
I can hear your heartbeat, Fenla.
Melchior.
No matter where I am, I hear it beating.
And I hear yours. Wait.
What?
No, we're not supposed to.
What? Not supposed to what? Love? I don't know, is there such a thing? I hear your heartbeat, Fenla. I feel your breathing everywhere. The rain, the hay. What? Sinful?
No. I don't know.
Then why? Because it's good? Because it makes us feel something?
Oh, I believe. Don't be scared. I believe.
No!
What?
Don't!
Please! All will be forgiven. I believe. Oh, I believe.
Wait!
Trust me.
There's love in heaven.
All will be forgiven.
There is love in heaven.
All will be forgiven.
There is love in heaven.
All will be forgiven.
There is love in heaven.
I believe.
All will be forgiven. There is love in heaven.
As dubious, as old. But let us pose this question. Each of us, within our dark hearts, in what ways have we honored or dishonored our mother and father? In what ways have we strayed in soul and body from the wise instruction of our clergymen, our teachers?
Are you all right, Fedma?
Something started crazy. Sweet and unknown. Something you keep in a box on the street. Now it's longing for a home. Wake me in time to be lonely and sad. This is a season for dreaming. And now our bodies are the guilty ones who touch, color the hours. Night won't breathe. Oh, how we fall in silence from the sky and whisper some silver.
Venmo.
I think so. Yes.
Horses gone and racing. All fits and starts. Window by window, you try to look into this brave new you that you are.
You say what dreams are.
Wake me in time to be out in the cold.
You say what we are.
This is the reason for dreaming.
And now our bodies are the guilty ones. Our touch will fill every hour. Huge and dark.
Ah, but
beloved children, in what ways have we cloaked and strayed even from ourselves the secret bargains we've made with our own devils?
Be a little butterfly, just winging over things and nothing deep inside. Nothing going wild in you, you know. You're slowing by the riverside, or floating high and blue. Or maybe cool to be a little summer wind, like once through everything and then away again. With a taste of dust in your mouth all day, but no need to know. Like sadness, you just sail away. I don't do sadness. Hey, I done my time. Looking back on it all, man, it blows my mind. I don't do sadness, so been there. Don't do sadness, just don't care.
More steeple?
Ilsa?
Did you lose something?
Why did you frighten me? Damn it.
What are you looking for?
If only I knew.
Then what's the use in looking?
So, where have you been keeping yourself?
Priapia, the artist con.
Yes.
All those old buggers, Moritz. All so wild, so bohemian. All they want to do is dress me up and paint me. That Johann Ferendorf, he's a wicked one, actually. Always chasing me and knocking easels down and dabbing me with his paintbrush. But then, that's men. If they can't stick you with one thing, they'll try another. Oh, God, Moritz, the other day, we all got so drunk, I just passed out in the snow. Just lay there, unconscious, all night. And then I spent a week with Gustav Baum, truly inhaling that ether of his. Until this morning, when he woke me with a gun set against my breast. He said, "One twitch, and it's the end." Really gave me the goosebumps. But how about you, Moritz? Still in school?
Well, this semester I'm through.
Oh, God. You remember how we used to run back to my house and play pirates? Ben LeBerkman, Melchior Gabor, you and I.
Whistling, it's got you. With its heartache, with its sorrow, winter wind sings and it cries. Spring and summer, sudden drift of the rain. Spring and summer.
Actually, I better go.
Walk as far as my house with me.
And?
And we'll dig up those old tomahawks and play, Moritz, just like we used to.
We did have some remarkable times hiding in our wigwams.
Yes, and I'll brush your hair and curl it and set you on my little hobby horse.
I wish I could.
Then why don't you?
80 lines of Virgil, 16 equations, a paper on the Habsburgs. So maybe I should be some kind of laundry line. Hang their things on me, and I will swing them dry. You just wave in the sun through the afternoon and then see. They come to set you free beneath the rising moon. Cause you know. Good night, Ilsa.
Good night?
Virgil, the equations, remember?
Just for an hour.
I can't.
Well, walk me at least.
Honestly, I wish I could.
You know, by the time you finally wake up, I'll be lying in some trash heap.
For the love of God, all I had to do was say yes. Ilsa! Ilsa! So what will I tell them? I'll tell them all. The angels. I got drunk in the snow and sang and played pirates. Yes, I'll tell them. I'm ready now. I'll be an angel. Ten minutes ago, you could see the entire horizon. And now, only the dusk, those first few stars. So dark. So dark. So dark.
Thank you.
his hands, you smoothed his tie, you gently lift his chin. Were you really so blind and unkind to him? Can't help the itch to touch, to kiss, to hold him once again. Now to close his eyes, never open them. A shadow passed, yearning, yearning for the food it called a home. All things he never did are left behind. All the things his mama wished he'd bear in mind, and how his dad had hoped he'd grow. Understand, you just let him cry, make a man out of him. A shadow passed, yearning, yearning for the fool he called a home. All things he never lived or left. All the things his mama did to make him mind, and how his dad had hoped he'd grow. All things he ever lived or left behind, all the fears that that he'd come to own.
We must take immediate and decisive steps, lest we be perceived as one of those institutions afflicted by the veritable epidemic of adolescent suicide.
Indeed, sir, but it will not be an easy war to win. There is not only the moral corruption of our youth, but the creeping sensuality of these liberal-minded times.
I couldn't agree more. It's war! Naturally, there must be casualties.
Naturally!
Bring the boy in.
Certainly, Herr Nochenbruch.
It would seem, young man, that all roads end in you. You do know what I'm talking about.
I'm afraid I don't...
As well one should be. 2 days after the father learned of the young...
Mordstiefel's
death, he searched through the boy's effects and found a certain depraved and atheistic document which made terribly clear...
Terribly clear!
...the utter moral corruption of the young man. A corruption which, no doubt, hastened the boy's end.
Without question, Herr Nockenbruch.
I am referring to, as you may know, to a 10-page essay entitled, coyly enough, The Art of Sleeping With, accompanied by, shall we say, lifelike illustrations.
Sir, if I could only...
Behave properly? Yes, there would be an entire other affair. For our part, we have done a thorough examination of this obscene document and compared it with that of the handwriting of every single pupil.
If you could only show me one obscenity.
You are to only answer the previously stated questions with a swift and decisive yes or no. Melchior Gabor, did you write this?
Did you write this?
There's a moment you know you're fucked. Not an inch more room to self-destruct. No more moves, oh yeah, the dead end zone. Man, you just can't call your soul your own.
But the thing that makes you really jump is that the weirdest shit is still to come. You can ask yourself, hey, what have I done? You're just a fly. The little guys, they kill for fun.
Man, you're fucked if you just freeze up. Can't do that thing that keep it still.
You're fucked if you speak your mind.
And you know, you will. Yeah, you're fucked, alright. And all for spite, you can kiss your sorry ass goodbye. Totally fucked, will they mess you up? Well, you know they're gonna try.
Blah, 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 blah.
Blah, 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 blah.
Hey, Gabor!
Disappear, yeah, well, you wanna try. Wanna bundle up into some big-ass lie. Long enough for them to all just quit. Long enough for you to get out of it.
Hey, Gabor, answer me!
Yeah, you're fucked, alright. And all for spite, you can kiss your sorry ass goodbye. Totally fucked, will they mess you up? Well, you know they're gonna try. Your sorry ass goodbye. Totally fucked, will they mess you up? Well, you know they're gonna try. Blah, 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 blah,
peaceful.
I know. Sometimes when it's quiet in the evening like this, I like to imagine myself as a country pastor with my red-cheeked wife, my library, my degrees,
Boys and girls who live nearby give me their hands when I go walking?
You can't be serious. Really, Ernst, you're such a sentimentalist. The pious, serene faces you see on the clergymen, it's all an act to hide their envy. Trust me, there's only three ways a man can go. He can let the status quo defeat him, like Moritz. He could rock the boat like Melchior and be expelled. Or he can bide his time and let the system work for him, like me. Think of the future as a pail of whole milk. One man's sweats turning into butter, like Otto. Another man spills his milk and frets and cries all night, like Georg. And as for me, well, I'm like a pussycat. I just skim off the cream.
Just skim off the cream?
Exactly.
But what about the... You're laughing. What? Hanchen?
Come cream away the bliss. Travel the world within my lips. Fondle the pearl of your distant dreams. Haven't you heard the word of your body? Oh, you're gonna be wounded. Oh, you're gonna be my wound. Oh, you're gonna bruise too. Oh, I'm gonna be your bruise.
Oh God!
My no. You know, 30 years, I'll look back on tonight, and everything will just seem so incredibly beautiful.
And in the meantime?
Well, why not?
When I came here this afternoon, I thought perhaps we'd only talk.
So are you saying that you're sorry that we...
No! I love you, Hanchen, as I've never loved anyone.
And so you should.
Oh, I'm gonna...
Bourgeoisie society works. Now, everything we touch is turned to dirt. In the end, we have only each other. We must build a different world. Despite what those whispering elders may say, I must set my head against your breast. We must let ourselves breathe and move again in that paradise.
Now, now, child, don't fret. I've been prescribing these since before you were born. In fact, I recently prescribed them to the young Baroness von Witzelburn. 8 days later, I'm pleased to report, she's off to a spa in Paramount, breakfasting on roast chicken and new potatoes. So, my child, three a day, and in 3 weeks, you'll be just fine. Breakfasting on suckling pig, no doubt.
So that's all it is, Doctor? Anemia?
Say toot!
And the nausea?
Not uncommon. Trust me, child, you'll be fine. Frau Bergman, could I speak with you for a minute?
Certainly, doctor. What have you done to yourself, to me, Venla?
I don't know.
You don't know?
Dr. Vimblesperver said I'm anemic.
Well, probably. You're going to have a child.
A child? But I'm not married.
Precisely. Venla, what have you done?
I don't know. Truly. I don't.
Oh, I think you do. And now I need to know his name.
His name? But what are you?
Death?
But how could that? I just wanted to be with him. To
but
hold him
face closer. You'll break my heart.
Why didn't you tell me everything?
Well, you are going to have to tell me who. Venla, I'm waiting. Georg Zierschnitz? Then who? Hanschen Rillow? Mort Stiefel? Melchior Gabor? Venla, Melchior Gabor? Venla!
Followed your lead. We have given the boy room. Now he must eat the bitter fruit. He has shown himself entirely corrupt.
He has not.
Hear me out.
But I have. Melchior wrote an essay, every word of which was true. Are we so afraid of the truth that we will join the ranks of cowards and fools, twisting his naive act into evidence against him? I will not have Melchior sent to a reformatory, pent up with degenerates and genuine criminals.
See the father bent in grief, the mother dressed in mourning, sister crumples, and the neighbors grumble, the preacher issues warnings.
Now I must break your heart. This afternoon, Frau Bergman came to me, bearing a letter Melchior wrote to young Vendela, saying that he has no regret for what transpired in our hayloft.
Impossible.
That he only longs for that bit of paradise.
Let me see that.
Yes, do have a look.
History. Such a sin, mystery. Home alone on a school night, harvest moon over the blue lands, summer longing on the wind.
wretched fact is, Melchior knew exactly what he was doing. And as that essay shows, he knew the dangers of doing it. And yet he went ahead, destroying himself and all but defiling that poor girl. So you tell me, Fanny, what do we do?
What do you will. A reformatory.
Had a sweetheart on his knees, so faithful and adoring, and he touched me, and I let him love me, so let that be my story.
Dear Melchior, I only pray this letter reaches you. I've written so many, I've heard nothing back. This evening, when Mama falls asleep, I will leave here and come to you. I will find you in that terrible place. They must let me see you. I have such remarkable news. Something's happened, Melchior, something I can barely understand myself.
Oh, what happened to you, man?
But, faster.
All right, now each one of you animals give me a coin.
Reinhold can put in for both of us.
I beg your pardon.
All right, you calm down. Reinhold, cough it up. Christ. All right, you two.
What are you looking at?
Who?
Gabor.
Oh, he just wants a part of the sport.
Thank you.
Oh no, he wouldn't want to dirty his hands.
Saving it for better things?
What's that supposed to mean?
Good girl, wasn't she?
Poor boy was never taught what parlor maids are for.
Oh no, he was too busy fucking his slut.
Shit!
Oh, careful. Razor burn.
Bastard.
What's this? A letter from his bitch?
My dear Melchior, I only pray this letter reaches you. I've written so many and have heard nothing back. Hold on, it gets better.
Frau Berg.
Thank you for meeting me. Your name was given to me by a doctor friend. My daughter.
I understand. Now listen to my instructions carefully. This Thursday, after midnight, bring the girl to me. Gartenstrasse, number 11. Knock three times, and three times only.
But my daughter, the procedure, is it safe?
We do what we can.
In my bed each night, I have so many dreams of the better world that we will build together with our child.
Child?
You didn't know. You put a pup in the bitch and you didn't even know!
Get him!
Grab him!
But where are we going, Mama?
Frau Bergman. Good. We'll take her now.
Mama! Mama!
I'll be with you every
Mama.
Moment!
Mama, please! Mama, please don't leave me! Mama!
Ilsa, I have been running for days, but at last I am back. Now, I beg you, for the sake of our old friendship, bring Venla to meet me tonight in the graveyard behind the church.
Oh no.
I will be there at midnight. Melchior Gabor.
So he hasn't heard.
Waiting for Venla.
Poor Melchior.
Poor Venla.
Dunlop? Look at this. Spend your entire life running from the church, and where do you wind up? Mort's, my old friend. I won't let them get to me. Or Venlai. I won't let it happen. Midnight. Off these tombs and you hear a fresh one. Here lies the grave of Venlaberg. No. Born, died of anemia? Then the two? Through the dark, the moon alone, they're burning. The stars, too, they tell of spring returning. And summer with another wind that no one else has known.
They call me love far behind.
Distant night, I won't let them stray from my heart. Through the wind, through the light, through the winter night, I will read all their dreams to the stars. I'll walk now with them.
Not gone.
I'll call on their names.
Not gone.
I'll see their thoughts are known.
Not gone.
Not gone. Not gone, they'll walk with my heart.
Not gone.
Never let them go.
Not gone.
Never let them go.
Not gone.
never let them go. You watch me, just watch me, I'm calling. I'm calling, and one day all will know.
So cool.